leading off of the Gamecocks. And
welcome to Jackie Jones Field here on March 15th, a Thursday, with a game that's beginning at 5:42 as we speak. The first batter for Screven County, number 3, Ross Cruz, is stepping in. And of course, this is a non-region matchup between the Toombs County High School Bulldogs and the Screven County Gamecocks. The first pitch of the game is in for a strike to Ross Cruz. On the mound today for Toombs County is Kyle Knight. At third, Brock Harrison. Short, Bryce DeLoach. Second, Noah Anderson. First, Martin Stevens. Behind the plate, Cole Graham. Next pitch fouled off. Out in the outfield, you have Trey Cloud in left, Dalton McBride in center, and Willie Campbell in right. I'll get to the Bulldog lineup in just a few moments. Now batting for Screven, Ross Cruz, who is currently up to bat with an 0-2 count, playing second. John Pollock batting second, catching. Jonathan Roberts batting third, playing third. Keyshawn Roberts batting cleanup and left. Dawson Griffin batting fifth, pitching today. Batting sixth is Jordan Hodges, playing short. Batting seventh is Griffin Smith. Next pitch hits the batter right on the hand. He's going to get down to second for first. Batting eight is Wilson Boyd, who is DHing today for Chase Thompson, who was playing center. Batting last is Edward Lovett, playing right. Now this lineup, compared to the last time we played Screven down in Sylvania, of course that was a non-region game as well, so a lot of substitutions and a lot of pitching changes. The pitcher today is Dawson Griffin. First pitch to John Pollock. He showed bunt, did not go. Ball one. Let's see. Dawson Griffin did pitch against Toombs County when they were in Screven. So Pollock's going to bunt this one down to the pitcher Kyle Knight. Kyle throws it to first, where Noah Anderson was covering out there. So one down to bring up the third baseman, Jonathan Roberts.
With one away, number 7, Jonathan.
Runner at second. Now, the Dogs had a lead against Screven for most of the game when we were down in Sylvania. They let Screven score 2 runs in the very first inning, and they didn't score another one until the 5th. Then they scored 2 in the 6th, swing and a miss by Jonathan Roberts. And then 1 in the 7th, and that was the walk-in run on a hit by a pitch. That's how they lost the game. The bases were loaded with 2 down, and they hit a batter, and it walked in the winning run. Next pitch to Jonathan Roberts is way outside, ball 1. Counts 1 ball and 1 strike on the third baseman. Need to adjust the mic to where you can't hear me breathing. You still can hear me. Need to put it a little lower. This next pitch is going to be hit into left field, foul in the corner. So strike 2. Now this one thing you don't do, especially when you're on the air, is adjust the mic or play with the headsets. They can hear it on the radio. Doesn't sound that good. Which I'm still doing. So Jonathan Roberts steps back in. He has 1 ball and 2 strikes. Kyle Knight requesting a different ball. Got a runner at second. Knight working from the stretch. Gives a look at Ross Cruz at second. Delivers to the plate. Hit the batter. So he's going to get down to first. Runners on first and second to bring up Keyshawn Roberts, playing left field today for the Screven County game.
Next up for Strava, number 20, Roberts, with number 17, Griffin.
Still adjusting the mic. Oh, there we go. Keyshawn Roberts is up to bat right now with runners on first and second. The first pitch to him is going to be low for ball 1. Let's see, when we were down in Sylvania, he went 2-for-3 with a hit by a pitch. He's a pretty good batter. Probably why he's hitting cleanup. Next pitch to him is going to be on the outside corner for a strike. Now the count's even at 1. Kyle Knight working from the stretch. Again, this is a non-region game here at Jackie Jones today. The next region game will be tomorrow here, same time, against Benedictine. The 1-1. Low and outside. Now the count's 2 balls and 1 strike. On the cleanup batter for Screven County, wearing number 20 and batting from the right-hand side. The lineup for Toombs County, other than the heart of the lineup, has had, well, just the beginning of the lineup, really, the first two batters. There are no freshmen batting in today's lineup for Toombs County. Next pitch over the outside corner in first strike to make it 2 balls and 2 strikes. But from the number 3 batter down, it looks like a lineup I've seen before. So, not too many changes. So 2 balls and 2 strikes on Keyshawn Roberts with the runners on first and second. And here's the pitch. Swings, knocks this one on the ground to shortstop Bryce DeLoach. Comes over and throws it to third for 1 out. So that'll be 2 down. Put runners on first and second to bring up the pitcher today for Screven County, Dawson Griffin. Wearing number 17 and batting from the right-hand side.
Next up, number 17, Griffin, and number 23, Hodges.
Stepping in, Kyle Knight giving a look. Jonathan Roberts down at second, who had the lead. Also the runner at first, Keyshawn Roberts. Here's the pitch. It's in for a strike. Nothing in 1. Knight. Coming back onto the mound. Waiting a sign from catcher Cole Graham. Comes set, gives a look at his runners. And delivers the 0-1. This ball's going to be hit high up into the air in the left field to Trey Cloud. He's going back and makes the catch for out number 3. So coming up for Toombs County in the bottom of the first, Bryce DeLoach, Trey Cloud, and Brock Harrison. That's coming up on Y101. Well, welcome to the bottom of the first inning here at Jackie Jones Field. Coming up for the Dogs, Bryce DeLoach, Trey Cloud, and Brock Harrison. Followed by Martin Stevens, Cole Graham, Dalton McBride, Kyle Knight, Willie Campbell, and Noah Anderson. Now, a few of these batters you haven't seen for a while, so their batting averages are the same. The batting averages I have, the last update is on March 11th. 15 games, they batted in that one. Today, down in Savannah. He went 2-for-3 with an RBI single and a single against freshman pitcher
leading off for the Dogs in the bottom of the first, number 10, Bryce DeLoach.
Barney used the words freshman sensation to describe him. Yes, he was a freshman. He pitched pretty well, left-hander. You don't see a pitching performance like that in a varsity game from too many freshmen. Bryce DeLoach is stepping in, batting from the right-hand side. The first pitch from Dawson Griffin is low and away. Ball 1. Next pitch is in for a strike. Now the count's even at 1. Griffin pitching from the windup. DeLoach steps back in. delivers the 1-1, swing, and a miss, strike two. Just one ball and two strikes on the shortstop for Toombs County today. Bryce DeLoach. Griffin delivers the 1-2, swing, and a miss, strike three. And one down to bring up sophomore Trey Cloud. Batting from the left-hand side and playing left field today. During his middle school days, Trey Cloud played the first base position and some center field for the Toombs County Middle School Bullpups. Then, under head coach Ryan Rogers, first pitch outside, making it ball one. And the head coach for the middle school baseball team, currently Travis Blewett. Next pitch is also outside. So two balls and no strikes, along with assistant Rob Hilton, who's also the Toombs County High School swim coach. Next pitch over the outside edge and for a strike. Now the count's two balls and one strike. Hilton has been coaching. Let's see, this will be his fifth year with the middle school Bullpup baseball team. This will be Blewett's second. The next pitch in the dirt for ball three, making it three balls and one strike on Trey Cloud. Trey Cloud also pitched for the Toombs County Middle School Bullpups. Also pitched some for the junior varsity last year. And still pitches for the junior varsity this year. And Trey's going to get on with a walk. So a runner at first with one down for Brock Harrison. Junior Bulldog.
Number five, Harrison, with number one, Mark Stevens on deck.
Now, when you come to describe Brock, there's not one position you can really give him. He's literally played just about every position on the baseball field. I can give a position he plays regularly. First pitch outside. He plays third, but sometimes shifts over and plays short for the varsity Bulldog baseball team. Throw back over to Cloud at first. Gets back safely. On deck, senior Bulldog Martin Stevens. Griffin delivers outside and low, making the count two balls and no strikes on Brock Harrison. Harrison steps back in. Griffin, now working from the stretch, comes set and delivers the 2-0 on the outside corner for a strike. Taking the count, two balls and one strike on Brock Harrison. Brock's older brother, Bryce, currently attending UGA. Griffin delivers the 2-1. High and inside. Make the count, three balls and one strike. So Harrison steps back in. Griffin comes onto the mound. Working from the stretch, Cloud going in for a strike. Here's a throw down to second. Cloud there safely, plenty of time. Stolen base by Cloud to put a runner in scoring position for the Bulldogs. So Brock steps back in with a full count.
Good job. Keep it running.
Griffin comes set, gives a look back at Cloud at second. And delivers the full count pitch to Harrison. Ball four.
Good job, Ryan.
So runners on first and second for senior dog Martin Stevens.
Next up, number one, Martin Stevens.
In the Benedictine game on Tuesday, Martin Stevens went 1-for-3. The base hit, reaching on an error by the pitcher, and grounding out to the shortstop. So with one down, see if the lefty can score some runs for the Dogs. First pitch, swing and a miss. Strike one. On deck, catcher Cole Graham. Griffin comes set, giving a look at his runners. And delivers to the plate, swing and a miss. Strike two. Eating up the inside of the plate on lefty Martin Stevens. Stepping back in. Griffin looking down. Receiving the sign from his catcher, John Pollock. Setting up for an outside pitch here. Here's 0-2. Low. Now it counts one ball and two strikes on Martin Stevens. Griffin comes set, gives a look back at Cloud at second. He's going to throw it back to Cloud. The tag was applied. He got back, lost the ball.
Go, Martin. Contact, baby.
Martin Steven wearing number one for the Toombs County High School baseball team. Steps back in. Griffin comes set. Winding and delivers the 1-2. Here's the throw down to third. Cloud and Harrison went. Both there safely. Now the count's two balls and two strikes on Martin Stevens with runners in second and third. So he steps back in. Runners definitely in scoring position now. See if the Dogs are able to score these two guys. On second and third. Griffin comes set and delivers the 2-2 to Stevens. Swings, knocks this one out into the air to center field. He's running in. No catch will be made. Harrison stays at second, but Trey Cloud runs across the diamond. Martin Stevens with an RBI single. So with runners on first and second with one down, that'll bring up junior catcher Cole Graham. On deck, center fielder Dalton McBride. It's a great game against Benedictine. From my score, he only allowed two hits. Benedictine, scorekeeper for them, said three. One of them I scored with an error. Here's a pitch to Graham outside. One ball, no strikes. Bulldogs currently leading Screven County 1-0 on an RBI single by Martin Stevens. Here's the 1-0 to Graham. Outside low, making it two balls and no strikes. Now this is a non-region game, so you're probably going to see a lot of changes in pitching. I know Screven down in Sylvania, they changed the pitcher every inning. Here's the 2-0. Outside, making it three balls and no strikes. Cole Graham wearing number 26. Batting from the right hand side. Griffin comes set. Gives a look back at Brock at second and delivers the 3-0. Gonna be in for a strike. Counts three balls and no strikes. Or three balls and one strike for Cole Graham. Griffin, working from the stretch, comes set, delivers the 3-1. Ball's going to be hit on the ground of the third baseman. Fields it, has it, fires to second, and the throw to first. Was it in time? No, it was not. So runners on the corners to bring up Dalton McBride. And two down. See if the Dogs can score even more. Send in a pinch runner for Graham. That's number three, Chandler Lynn, who in last game's performance went 0 for 3 at the dish. So McBride receiving the sign from head coach Brian Fitzgerald, who was in his last year as the head coach of the Toombs County High School baseball team. McBride steps in wearing number 18. Playing center field today. Griffin comes set. Chandler Lynn's going at first. Pitches in for a strike. Now you have runners on second and third. So two runners are in scoring position for the senior Bulldog. Dalton McBride. Griffin comes set and delivers the 0-1. Outside low, Harrison goes back to third. Throw that away from the catcher there. So one ball and one strike on Dalton McBride. And Griffin working from the stretch. Receiving the sign from catcher John Pollock. Comes set. Looks at his runners on base, winding, and delivers the 1-1. Ball's going to be fouled off. They got one ball and two strikes on Dalton McBride, who also went 0-for in Benedictine's game. As he mentioned in his interview, he has been struggling at the plate lately. See what he can do right here with one ball and two strikes. Griffin comes set and delivers, swings, and also fouls this one off. Coach Fitzgerald constantly telling his Bulldog offensive team to stay behind the ball. I just heard him say it once again. Also mentioned that in his interview, which aired on Wednesday. Coach Fitzgerald always does a good job of giving pretty decent-sized interviews, which is a good thing. Here's the 1-2, high, making the count two balls and two strikes on Dalton McBride. Griffin, receiving the sign, comes set, gives a look at his runners, and delivers the 2-2, swings, this ball's going to be hit back up the middle for a base hit by Dalton McBride. One run's going to score easy. Chandler Lynn's rounding third, and he's going to come home standing to put the Bulldogs up 3-0. A two-run RBI single for Dalton McBride. So with two down and a runner at first, he's going to bring up the pitcher, Kyle Knight.
Next up, number 25, Kyle Knight. Number 28, Willie Campbell on deck. Two away.
On deck, senior dog Willie Campbell. Last four batters in today's lineup for Toombs County, all four seniors. And Griffin comes set. McBride's going. Ball is in for a strike. McBride down a second. Knight steps back in. Runner now down to second. Griffin gives a look back at McBride. And there's a throw. Ricochets off second shortstop's glove. McBride's going to get down to third. Here's the throw. He's there safely. So now, Dalton McBride is definitely in scoring position. Kyle Knight can drive him in. One strike on Kyle Knight. Griffin comes set, giving a look at McBride on third. And delivers the 0-1. This ball is going to be hit up into the air into right center field. Right fielder moving over and makes the catch for out number three. So the Dogs do a pretty good job here in the top bottom of the first inning, scoring three runs as we break going into the second inning on Y101.
Where the party's at. This is how we do.
Up to bat for Screven County here in the top of the second inning. Jordan Hodges, Griffin Smith, Wilson Boyd, the DH, and Edward Lovett. Brand throwing the ball down. And Jackie Jones today. Non-region game. Toombs County Gamecocks. Toombs County School System does not have school tomorrow, but there is a home region game here in Jackson Jones. Toombs County getting another shot at Benedictine, losing by a 1-point margin, 2-1. We initially took the lead, but later on we've lost it. So Kyle Knight coming set. We're going to deliver the pitch. The shortstop, Jordan Hodges, in for a strike. Count nothing in one. On deck, number 24, Griffin Smith, the first baseman. Knight working from the windup. Gonna deliver the 0-1 outside. Look at the count, one ball and one strike on Jordan Hodges. Comes set, delivers the pitch. Ball's gonna be hit on the ground foul. Third baseman Brock Harrison. Now that counts one ball and two strikes on Jordan Hodges. Ever sat in the press box at Jackie Jones while the sun's glaring right in your face? No, it's terrible. Probably should have bought some sunglasses. Turned some in my car. Can't leave now. Here's the 1-2 from Knight. This ball is going to be hit on the ground to Brock Harrison. Fields it, has it, fires to first. Stevens makes the catch for out number one. So one down to bring up the first baseman, Griffin Smith. Wearing number 24 today. When we played them down in Sylvania, he did not. Griffin Smith was an extra player. Actually, he did bat. No, he did not bat. So the first pitch to him is outside and high. He goes for it, in for a strike. Yes. Nothing in one. Knight pitching from the windup. And delivers the 0-1. Low. Counts one ball and one strike. On deck's the DH today, Wilson Boyd. Batting for number two, Chase Thompson, who's playing center field. Here's the pitch. Swing. And a miss. Strike two.
It was a strike, Kyle. Look good.
In the process of that pitch,
with all that hair coming forward and it tripped.
Kyle may have stepped in a hole there on the mound. Fell just a little bit. Was in for a strike still.
That was a psych move, wasn't it, Kyle?
He's filling that hole in right now.
Psych.
One ball and two strikes on Screven County's first baseman. He's stepping back in. Knight pitching from the windup. Comes set and delivers the 1-2. Did he go? I guess not. Asking down the first base umpire, he did not go. So two balls and two strikes. Knight comes set and delivers the 2-2. Swing and a missed strike three. So two down to bring up Wilson Boyd. Wearing number 10 and is the DH today.
Next up, number 10, Wilson Boy.
Now, Wilson Boy also has a brother on the team named Weston Boy, who is not in the starting lineup for Screven. First pitch to him is going to be high and outside. See, Wilson Boyd went 0 for 2, reaching on an error by the third baseman, an error by the second baseman. If I am correct, here's the 1-0 from ninth swing. Miss. They have one ball and one strike on Weston Boyd. Ninth coming set, still working from the windup, no one on base. Delivers the 1-1. This ball's going to be hit on the ground to senior second baseman Noah Anderson. Fields it and fires to first in time for out number 3. So a 3-up and 3-down inning for Kyle Knight in his Toombs County defense. As we break, coming up, Lee Campbell, Noah Anderson, and then back to the top on Y101. Welcome back to Jackson Jones. On the bottom of the second inning, Dogs leading 3-0 in a non-region game against Screven County. Now, a Y101 worker is
leading off
for
the Dogs on the bottom of the second. Number 28, Lee Campbell, number 16.
Anytime on the show. Y101 supervisor. This pitch by Willie Campbell is knocked into right center field for a base hit for the senior Bulldog.
Go, Willie!
So a runner at first to bring up Noah Anderson. And I'm talking about Tone Tone. His birthday is today. Not sure how old he's turning. Doesn't matter. I'm sure he's listening. So happy birthday.
Next up, number 16, Noah Anderson.
Noah Anderson, wearing number 16's up to bat on the season. He is 313. 5 for 16. As he steps in, runner at first. Showing bunt. Throw back to first. An attempt to get Willie Campbell. He slides back safely. Griffin coming on to the mound. Pitching from the stretch. Pitch to the plate. Outside. On Anderson. Anderson showing bunt once again. Griffin delivers. He's going to hit this one over the second baseman's head out in the right center field for a base hit. The right fielder didn't get a good jump on it. So Anderson's going to get down to second and Campbell down to third. On a double for Noah Anderson. So now you have runners in scoring position. This could be a big inning for the Dogs. For junior Bryce DeLoach.
Makes sense for the Dogs.
His first bat, he struck out on a 1-2 count. See if he can't do something big here for Toombs County. Griffin working from the windup now. Comes set and delivers. Swing. And a miss. Strike one. Griffin. Here's a look at Campbell on third, delivers the 0-1. This ball is going to be swinging bunt down to the pitcher Griffin, fields it, fires to first. In time, Willie Campbell's coming home. There will be no throw, actually a throw, but it's late, and Noah Anderson getting down to third. Score that as a sacrifice grounder by Bryce DeLoach, scoring a run there. So now the Dogs are leading 4-0. So with one down and a runner at third, it's going to bring up sophomore Trey Cloud, batting from the left-hand side, playing left field here today. Time has been called by the umpire. I think he was telling some of the Bulldog dugout to get back in. So Griffin working from the windup, Noah Anderson on third. Here's the pitch to Cloud, way outside. for ball one. Coming back on, Cloud stepping back in, reached on a walk in his last at bat. Griffin comes set and delivers the 1-0. Low. And the count's two balls and no strikes on Trey Cloud. Griffin giving a look at his runner and delivers the 2-0. In for a strike, throw back down to third. Anderson was tagged out. Two down. So now you have two down for Trey Cloud. Counts two balls and one strike. On the sophomore Bulldog. Next pitch, swing and a miss, strike two. Griffin sort of working back here. Counts even at two on Cloud with two down. Pitch is low and inside. Now you have a loaded count. Griffin comes set and delivers the full count pitch to Cloud. Fouls this one off towards the Bulldog side. Cloud steps back in. Griffin steps back on. And delivers the full count pitch. Swing. And a missed strike three. So the Dogs, they do score another run here in the bottom of the second inning to make it 4-0 as we break on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field here on Y101. The Dogs are ahead 4-0 as we are in the top of the third inning. Toombs County Dugout Club is selling a 2018 John Deere Z-Track Z355E 22 horsepower 48-inch cut zero-turn lawnmower and a 6x8 D&E trailer. All proceeds goes toward Toombs County Baseball. The drawing will be April 19th, which is senior night here at Jackie Jones, in a region game against Waynesboro. $20 apiece. See any Bulldog baseball player or any Bulldog baseball player press card. So the first pitch from Kyle Knight is going to be hit on the ground down to Brock Harrison. Fields up, lost it on the exchange, throws it, not in time. He had it, and during the exchange, lost it. So a runner at first to bring us back to the top of the Screven County Gamecock lineup to Ross Cruz. Playing second base today.
Next up, number three, Cruz, with an 11 Pollock home.
As he steps back in. Hit by a pitch in his first at bat, right on the hand, and no 2 count. And what you're looking for here, the double play ball. He's showing bunt, pulls back, in for a ball. So one ball and no strikes. Graham gets back behind the dish. Knight coming back onto the mound. Cruz stepping back in. On deck is catcher number 11, John Pollock. Knight delivers the 1-0, showing bunt again. He's going to get this one down. Graham comes out, picks it up, fires to second in time for the out.
Good throw, Cole.
So one down with a runner at first to bring up John Pollock. On deck, Jonathan Roberts.
Number 11, Pollock.
In his first at bat, John Pollock grounded into a fielder's choice, back to pitcher Kyle Knight. So Knight gives a look at Ross Cruz on first, comes set, and delivers to the dish. Ball low, making it one ball and no strikes. As he steps back in, Knight comes set. Gives a look at the runner, delivers the 1-0. Runner going, swing and a miss. Here's the throw down to second. Deloach has it, applies the tag. He slides in safely. The question mark there. The throw was there. Must have just tagged him too high. So the count's 1-1 on John Pollock with a runner now down to second. Knight comes set. Oh, that was a good throw, a good timing. Catcher Graham. This ball's gonna be hit onto the ground. A chopper. Third baseman has it, fires it to first in time for the out. Stevens comes off to make sure Ross Cruz goes nowhere. So that's a 5-3 and out made by Brock Harrison. So a runner at third with two down to bring up the third baseman, Jonathan Roberts, who in his first at bat, also got hit by a pitch on a 1-2 count. Knight comes set and delivers. Hot ball is high, making it 1-1 and no strikes on Jonathan Roberts. Bulldogs leading 4-0 here in the top of the third inning with two down. Knight pitching from the windup. Comes set and delivers over the outside edge for a strike. Now the count's even at 1. As he steps back in, Knight comes set and delivers the 1-1. In for a strike, nice curve ball. Now the count's 1-2. On Jonathan Roberts. See if the Dogs can get here, allowing Screven County to score no runs. Here's the 1-2, low and outside, making the ball, making the count 2-2. So Knight comes back on, working from the windup, runner at third. Receiving the sign from catcher Cole Graham and delivers the 2-2. Swings, pops this one up into the air, into left field. Dalton McBride comes over and makes the call, and more in the left center field. 4-3. So a 4-3, and the Bulldogs get out of that inning, allowing Screven to score none as we move to the bottom of the third. Dogs leading 4-0 with Harrison, Stevens, and Graham coming up to bat on Y101. Bottom of the third inning, Dogs leading 4-0 here on Y101. Jackson Jones today for non-weekend game. Dogs playing host Screven County Gamecocks. Now, the Toombs County High School Bulldog Dogs Against Cancer Club.
Leading off for the Dogs, number 5, Harrison, number 1.
They have made t-shirts for Barney. They are $15 a piece, and all proceeds goes directly towards Barney. As he is out of town, up in Atlanta. First pitch into Harrison is a ball. But he is listening. On the MixLR, Brock's going to hit this ball hard down the third base line. Third baseman not able to get a glove on it. But the left fielder does a great job of getting it in. Brock Harrison with the base hit. One down, or runner at first, what I meant to say. Bring up Martin Stevens.
Martin Stevens up the bat.
Now, Miss Megan Morris is over the selling of the t-shirts for Barney. She said she would sell them at the home games. I'm not sure if she's out there or not. Again, $15 a piece. Design was made by high school student Carly Morgan. So Griffin steps back on, now working from the stretch, bring up Martin Stevens, who had an RBI single in his first at bat. Griffin comes set, gives a look at Brock. Here's the pitch, low. Ball 1 to Martin Stevens. Griffin gives a look at Harrison. Gonna throw it back. Gets back safely. So Steven steps back in. Griffin comes set. This ball's gonna be hit down to the by the first baseman into right field. Brock Harrison is gonna scoot down to third, and Martin's gonna hold up at first. Martin reaching on an error by the first baseman. And now you have runners on the corners to bring up catcher Cole Graham.
Next up, number 26.
And his first at bat, he grounded into a fielder's choice. Let's see, Cole Graham can't hit Harrison in here. So Griffin comes set, working from the stretch, and delivers the pitch outside for ball one on Graham. He steps back in. Griffin comes set. And delivers the 0-1. Stevens going. No throw. Throw down to third, though. Third baseman bobbles the ball a little bit. Harrison gets back safely. So now runners are on second and third for Cole Graham. The bottom of the third here, dogs leading 4-0. See if they can't increase that lead here with runners on second and third. Pitch to Graham is low and inside to make it 3 balls and no strikes. So Griffin comes set, working from the windup now, and delivers a 3-0. In for a strike. Graham was about to start trotting down to first. I thought it was a ball as well. So three balls and one strike on Cole Graham. Griffin comes set, winding, and delivers. This ball's going to be hit onto the ground, down to the shortstop, Jordan Hodges. Fields it, fires over to first. First baseman makes a pick on it, but Brock Harrison scores. So a sacrifice grounder by Cole Graham. So one down with a runner at third. The Dogs now leading 5-0. To bring up Dalton McBride. In his first at bat, Dalton McBride had a 2-run RBI single. Griffin delivers the pitch. This ball is going to be hit. A chopper down to Jordan Hodges once again. Fields it. Fires to first in time, but another run scores. That's Martin Stevens. So a sack grounder for Dalton McBride. Up to bat now, pitcher Kyle Knight.
Next up, number 25, Kyle Knight. We're looking at one day, 2-0.
So far in this inning, the Dogs have one earned run and one unearned run. Swing and a miss by Knight. First pitch. Dogs leading 6-0 here in the bottom of the third inning. Playing host to Screven County here today. Next pitch hits Knight, and he trots down to first to give it to Willie Campbell. Willie batted in the top or the bottom of the second inning with the first batter up.
Next up for the Dogs, number 28, Willie Campbell.
And he reached on a single in right center field. They're going to send in a pinch runner for pitcher Kyle Knight. And that's freshman Bulldog Chase Musselman. The umpire is making that change.
Come on, Willie.
He steps back in. So Griffin comes set. Here's the throw. Willie hits this a line drive to the third baseman. Whatever his name is. Third baseman Jonathan Roberts. I thought that's what it was. For out number 3. So the Dogs score 3 more insurance runs here in the third, or 2 more insurance runs here in the third inning. They move into the top of the fourth. Dogs leading 6-0. Why 101? So the score is 6-0. 4-0 here at Jackie Jones Field. Dogs are doing an excellent job today at the plate, scoring runs. And Knights doing an excellent job on the mound. So that's going to bring up Keyshawn Roberts. Playing left field today in his first bat. He grounded into a fielder's choice. First pitch to him is inside for ball one. Here's the 1-0 from Knight in the dirt. Ball two. So two balls and no strikes on Keyshawn Roberts as he steps back in. Knight comes set and delivers. High. Now it counts three balls and no strikes on the left fielder, who is 0 for 1 today. Knight comes set, working from the windup, delivers a 3-0. It's going to be in for a strike to make it three balls and one strike. Now, sorry, didn't mean to hit the mic. The sports report tomorrow, it will air and it will be of this game. Here's the 3-1 from Knight, up high for ball four. It will air. Since I don't have school tomorrow, I don't know if it's gonna air for the 7:40. It might, for the 7:40, it might air the one from today. But it will air it for the 12:40. And of course the game tomorrow starts at 5:40, so you probably won't hear that one anyway. But the game starts at 5:45, and you probably won't hear the 5:40. I don't think you heard the one from today either. We started before it got through the system. He's gonna hit a dribbler down to Brock Harrison. Fields it, fires the first in time for the out. So one down with a runner at second to bring up shortstop Jordan Hodges, who's made a lot of plays for the Gamecocks here today. Which I will make an effort to get up out of bed tomorrow.
Next up, number 23,
my day off from school to get the sports report into the system.
One down.
But as a listener, you have to do your part and at least listen. Knight comes set, delivers to the plate. This ball is going to be hit back onto the ground to Bryce DeLoach. Fields it, fires the first in time for out number two. Okay, so Robin told me the 5:40 did air just before the game. I didn't hear it. I was away from the headphones at the time. But so it did air. So up to bat now is Griffin Smith, who struck out on a 2-2 count today. Here's the pitch. Low and away. I think the broadcast started, well, the game started more towards 5:40 than 5:45. I think the first pitch, believed it, I say 5:42? I did. So, yeah, it probably should have aired. I mean, you put it in the system, the way the system's set up, you put it in for 5:40, and it doesn't necessarily air at 5:40. The next pitch is in for a strike. It airs as soon as the songs from the satellite are done playing and the commercials that come along with it. Interesting how all that works, or at least to me. Here's the 1-1, swing and a miss, strike two on Griffin Smith, the first baseman here today. Kyle Knight working from the stretch with a runner at third. Comes set and delivers the 1-2, swing and a miss. Strike three. So four up, three down for the Dogs here in the fourth inning as we go into the bottom of the fourth. Dogs leading 6-0. Up to bat, Anderson, DeLoach, and Cloud on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field. Got a new pitcher here, number 27. He was not on my roster. Or not the roster, not on my lineup. Anderson's going to experience the first pitch from J.D. Johnson.
The bottom of the fourth, number 16,
see the other pitcher's name was Dawson Griffin. I'm not. I'm going to do a little bit of his statistical pitching in just a few moments. Actually, I guess I'm going to do it right now. First pitch to Anderson. High. He faced 17 batters and only one strikeout, or two strikeouts. Here's the pitch to Anderson on the inside corner for strike one. Did he allow a walk? He allowed two walks and several base hits. I'll have to do that in a second. Here's the 1-1. Anderson's going to hit this back up the middle. Will the shortstop Jordan Hodges get to it? Yes, he will. Picks it up. Fires to first. First baseman not able to make a clean catch on it. Ricochets off the tip of his glove. So Anderson down to first safely. I will have to give Jordan Hodges the shortstop credit, though. An excellent catch. An excellent attempt to get there. So Anderson reaching on an error to put a runner at first to bring up. Alex Gordy.
Next up for Toombs, number 11, Alex Gordy. And number 12, Trey
Crowder. Alex Gordy on the season is 1-for-4, batting 250. Let's see. Lost my train of thought there. Let's see. Oh, yeah. How many walks did he allow? He allowed two Bulldog walks. And we're speaking of Dawson Griffin. The new pitcher is J.D. Johnson. And he allowed one, two, three, four, five base hits. Yeah, five base hits. Six runs, and three out of the six were earned. So now pitching for Screven, J.D. Johnson. And up to bat, Alex Gordy. A freshman dog today, the first freshman to get some time at the plate. Now there are three freshmen on this varsity team that dress out every day. That's Alex Gordy, Chandler Lynn, and Chase Musselman. Musselman and Lynn both batted in the Benedictine and played in the Benedictine game on Tuesday. Here's the throw way over Gordy's head for ball one. Gordy plays for the junior varsity, plays second base. Johnson comes set, working from the stretch now, and delivers in for a strike. The count's now even at one. You have Coach Hunter Adams down at third right now, along with Patrick Kraft over at first. Kraft played many games out here on Jackie Jones Field back in his high school days. The next pitch gets by the catcher, John Pollock, and Anderson gets down to second. Counts two balls and one strike. Of course, if you haven't heard yet, Coach Brian Fitzgerald is in his last season here at Toombs County, coaching-wise. Here's the 2-1 to Gordy. Swings, knocks this one out into right field for a base hit. Anderson being held up at third, so Alex Gordy with a single to put runners on the corners for Trey Cloud.
Next up, number 12, Trey Cloud.
Cloud currently 0-1 today with a walk and a full count strikeout. Got a runner in scoring position here. Let's see if the Dogs can't score more runs. To continue, they've scored 3 in the first, 1 in the second, and 2 in the third. Here's the pitch to Cloud, going to be on the outside corner. Gordy going, no throw. So, no balls and one strike. Of course, I'm pretty sure Cloud might have gotten the take sign on that one for Gordy to go. Pitch was on the outside corner of the plate. So J.D. Johnson comes set, working from the stretch, delivers the 0-1, bounces out in front of the plate. Now he counts 1-1 on Cloud. On deck, Brock Harrison and Martin Stevens. Now, I didn't know this. Martin Stevens had a base hit in this game, which started a hitting streak for him, now to 3 games, which I guess the Benedictine game started it. Now it's been upgraded to 3 games. So J.D. Johnson comes set, delivers the 1-1 to the plate. Cloud's going to hit a chopper. Anderson is going to score, and Cloud's going to get to first. An RBI single for Cloud. To make 7-0 here in the fourth inning. With runners on the corners and no outs. To bring up junior dog Brock Harrison. Now Harrison is a dependable guy at the plate most of the time. I'm going to give a statistic at least 72% of the time. Now the run rule, again, just to remind you in case that does come into effect here, is 15 after 3, 12 after 4, and 10 after 5. We are 3 points, or from the run rule this inning, we are 5 points away. For next inning, we're only 3. Here's the pitch. It's in for a strike on Harrison. J.D. Johnson going back to the mound. Runners on first and third. Martin Stevens on deck. You have time. J.D. is down to tie his shoe. Now he's back up. Or no, he's still down. I looked away. I guess I assumed. Now he's standing back up. So no balls and 1 on Harrison as he steps back in. He's 1-1 today with a walk and a single. J.D. Johnson comes set. Cloud's going. Here's the pitch. Ball throw down to second. Not in time and offline. So 1-1 on Harrison. So he steps back in. Now, Brock's brother Bryce is here today, but his dad is not, and I know he's listening. He tells me that when he's not able to make these games and out of town, he listens. On XLR, next pitch behind Harrison to make it 2-1. So J.D. Johnson, I almost said J.D. Rogers, J.D. Johnson steps back on. And delivers the 2-1. Swing and a miss. Huge swing by Harrison. To make the ball count 2-2. So Johnson comes set and delivers the 2-2. Low and outside. Ball gets away from the catcher, not far enough for Gordy to go. To load up the count on Harrison. Now Harrison saw a full count and back in the first inning. Which he walked. So Harrison steps back in. Johnson comes back onto the mound. Comes set, working from the stretch, and delivers the 3-2. Harrison's going to pop this ball up over to the first baseman, and he makes the catch for out number 1. So with one down and runners on first and or second and third, it brings up Martin Stevens, who was 1-for-2 on the day with an RBI single and reaching on an error by the first baseman. On deck, number 26, catcher Cole Graham. Here's the pitch from Johnson. Martin's going to hit this one back up the middle for a definitely an RBI single. Clout is running around third, and he's coming home to make this game 9-0. A two-run RBI single for Martin Stevens. With one down and a runner on first, it brings up catcher Cole Graham. So Screven County coach is coming out. Will he make a pitching change? No, he's not. He's just talking to his pitcher. Infield staying back. Actually, I think we are. Number 24 is coming out onto the mound. And number 24 is Griffin Smith, who was playing first. So we are making a pitching change here in the bottom of the fourth inning. We're going to take a break. Dogs leading 9-0 as we break on Y101. Welcome back to the bottom of the fourth inning. Dogs leading 9-0 here on Y101 with a runner at first, and that's Martin Stevens. But up to bat, Cole Graham with one down. First pitch, he's going to get by the catcher, but it ricocheted off the fence. Stevens still down to first, second safely. Ricocheted off the fence. Perfect lineup for the catcher. So one ball and no strikes on Graham on deck. Senior dog Dalton McBride, who is 1-for-2 today. Stevens going to third. Here's the throw. He gets there safely. So you have a runner on third for Cole Graham. Let's see if the Dogs can't score some more runs here in the bottom of the fourth.
Way to go, one!
Here's the pitch from Griffin Smith. It's going to be inside, making the count 3 balls and no strikes on Graham. He was 0-for-2 today. Here's the next one for ball 4. So runners on the corners for Dalton McBride, who had a 2-run RBI single back in the first inning. They're sending in a runner for catcher Cole Graham. Number 3, Chandler Lynn.
Number 18, Dalton McBride up to bat for number 25, Knight on deck.
On deck, number 25, Kyle Knight, the pitcher today, who's 0-for-1 with a hit by a pitch. So McBride steps back in. Now Chandler is a pretty fast guy, so I'm gonna go ahead and assume he's probably gonna go to second pretty shortly. Stevens is on third. Here's the pitch to the dish. Oh, Lynn did not go off the plate. So one ball. Figured he would go. He's getting a lead. Here's the pitch from Smith. Swing and a miss. Throw it back down to third. Bounces over the third baseman's head. Stevens getting up. Left fielder was on the run in. Stevens is coming. Throw was offline. Chandler Lynn's getting down to third. So another run scores to make it 10-0. So with one down, Dalton McBride, runner at third. Bulldogs leading 10-0 here. And the bottom of the fourth inning, the Dogs are 2 runs away from the run rule coming into effect. And they could easily do that with one down. Chandler Lynn at third. Ball is in for a ball, so now it counts 2 balls and 1 strike. Just got a message from the birthday boy, Tone Tone. Your 2018 Lions Citizen of the Year is Ramon Powell from Lions. It's actually pronounced Ramon. He's kin to me, so a lot of people do assume it's Ramon, but it is Ramon. Ramon Powell. He is kin to me. Here's the 2-1 to McBride, low. But that ball four, I guess that was ball four. Yes, it was. So we have times on the field. For runners on first and third, now the coach is coming back out. Possibly gonna make another change in pitching here. I believe we are, we're bringing out somebody. Possibly going to the field, but again, your 2018 Citizen of the Year is Ramon Powell for Lions. We are making a pitching change. I believe that is number 3. Ross Cruz. So we're gonna take a break while he warms up. Dogs leading 10-0 in the bottom of the fourth inning on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field. We're here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Dogs leading 10-0 with Kyle Knight up to bat and one down. On the night, Kyle is 0-for-1, flying out to the right fielder and being hit by a pitch. So the pitcher now is Ross Cruz, number 3. Runner's going. Kyle Knight's going to hit this one out into left center field. One run's going to score easy. Dalton McBride's being held up at third. Actually, he's being sent. The ball got away.
Way to go, Dalton!
From the center fielder, so that is 12-0. That is 12-0, so are we gonna call that game? 4. Guess we're not. Which is a non-region game. The Dogs leading 12-0 on a 2-run RBI single by the pitcher Kyle Knight. Dogs are doing phenomenal at the plate here today.
Next up,
sending in Chase Musselman. So one down with a runner at first.
Excuse me, Willie Campbell.
With Willie Campbell up to bat.
Come on, Brian.
So Cruz comes set, delivers to the plate. Inside for ball one. I mean, at least off the run rule is 12 after 4. 15 after 3, 12 after 4, 10 after 5. Maybe it is. Next pitch is in for a strike, and we're just going to play a full game, considering it's a non-region game. Wouldn't it be something? Finishing this game before the lights even had to come on here at Jackie Jones. So Ross Cruz comes set, runner at first. Here's the pitch on the inside corner for strike 2. Now the count's 1-2 on Willie Campbell. Cruz backs off the mound. Musselman scoots back, who's running for pitcher Kyle Knight. Well, the run rule didn't apply here. I know this applies to the fifth inning. Here's the pitch to Willie Campbell. Fouls this one off back behind us. Count still 1-2 on Willie Campbell. He steps back in wearing number 28, senior Bulldog today, or not today, he has been for the whole year. So Ross Cruz comes set and delivers the 1-2 to Campbell, hits the dirt, Musselman no go. Now the count's 2-2. Dogs leading 12-0 here in the bottom of the fourth inning. The count is 2-2 on the senior Bulldog, who is 1-for-2 today. Swing and a miss. Strike 3. So with 2 down, that brings up Noah Anderson, who started this little snowball effect or domino effect or whatever you want to call it here in the fourth inning. guess it would be better called the snowball effect, because the snowball starts, it gets bigger continuously as it goes down the hill. And that's what the lead has done here at Jackie Jones today. The first pitch to Noah Anderson is in for a strike. Nothing in one. Runner at first, and that's Chase Musselman. Two down. Bottom of the fourth inning. Lights are still not on yet, which we have enough sunlight here to play. Here's the 0-1. Hits Anderson right on the back of the helmet, so he trots down to first. And that brings us back to the top of the order to Alex Gordy. They have runners on first and second with two down.
Number 11, Alex Gordy up to bat. And number 12, Trey Cloud on deck.
On deck, sophomore Trey Cloud. So Ross Cruz comes set. Here's the pitch and for a strike. Nothing in one on the freshman dog, who is one for one on today's game. Ross Cruz pitching from the stretch. You have runners on first and second. He comes set. Here's the pitch to the plate. High. Counts one ball and one strike. Ross Cruz looking down the barrel. Comes set. Musselman at second, Anderson at first. Here's the pitch, high. Gets off the catcher's glove. Musselman's going to get down to third, and Anderson's going to scoop down to second. So runners are now on second and third for Alex Gordy, the freshman Bulldog. Let's see if he can't do something here and score some more runs here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Pitcher now pitching from the windup, delivers the 2-1, swings, knocks this one on the ground, back to the pitcher, fields it, and fires the first for out number three.
No score.
Run did not score, but it's 12-0, dogs leading. Bottom of the fourth inning, going into the top of the fifth on Y101. We'll come back here to Jackie Jones. I was about to start to say something else, but turned into whatever that was. Welcome back to Toombs County here at Jackie Jones Field. Dogs playing very well today in a non-region matchup against Screven County. Currently winning 12-0 as we're going to change around the infield here. You have sophomore catcher Jaden Carroll behind the plate. Alex Gordy over at third. Luke Hanaway down at first. I think the outfield is still the same. Brock Harrison at short. And Noah Anderson is second. Seems like we're ready to begin here. I'm just figuring up the unearned run to unearned ratio from the fourth inning for the Dogs. See, there's one earned unearned run. I don't know why I can't get that out. There's one unearned run. Let's see. There's two earned runs. I think it's about three earned and just about three unearned. Sort of an even split there. I don't know. If Barney's listening, he will have it on the website correctly. Anyway, Dogs leading 12-0 here in the top of the fifth inning. Up to bat, number 10, Wilson Boyd. On deck is number 4. Look. Becton. That name sounds familiar. He played in the game down in Sylvania. First pitch, ball. Becton. Carson Becton on deck. He didn't play. He was extra player. Here's the pitch from Kyle Knight. Inside. Now that counts two balls and no strikes. On the DH today, Wilson Boyd. Knight working from the windup. Of course, no runners on base. Comes set and delivers the 2-0. So now the count's three balls and no strikes. Of Again, just recap, you now have Jaden Carroll behind the dish, Alex Gordy down at third, Brock Garrison over at short, Noah Anderson down at second, and Luke Hathaway over at first. Next pitch is in for a strike on Wilson Boyd, who grounded out to the second baseman Noah Anderson earlier in the game today. I believe here, dogs get three outs and maybe over. I don't know. I don't know if we're playing tomorrow. Because if we were, it would have been over just a few minutes ago. Here's a hit out to center field. Going to drop in for a base hit, which is the first base hit for Screven County on the ball game today. Messing up Kyle Knight's no-hitter he had going. So a runner at first.
Next up, number four, Becton.
To bring up number four, Carson Becton. On deck, the current pitcher, Ross Cruz. We're in the top of the fifth inning here. The pitch was a ball, I believe, yes. Knight now pitching from the stretch. What would be perfect right now? A double play. By your middle infielders who are currently Brock Harrison and Noah Anderson. Here's the next pitch. High. Two balls and no strikes. On Carson Becton. Knight comes set. He has a look at his runner. Winding and delivers a 2-0. No go from the runner. Now the count's three balls and no strikes on Carson Becton. Make my little box so I know that he's up to bat on my scorecard. Kyle Knight getting another ball. Dogs leading 12-0, top of the fifth inning. Here in a non-region game at Jackie Jones Field. The game's been running about an hour and a half. Here's the pitch. It's in for a strike, making the count three balls and one strike. Knight, a senior dog, wearing number 25, throws and hits all from the right-hand side. Comes set, working from the stretch, and delivers the 3-1 for ball four. So runners on first and second to bring up the pitcher Ross Cruz, who is 0 for 1 today. Now, I don't know about you, regardless of being up by a lead this much, shutting someone out, it's a lot better than allowing them to score anything. So the first pitch to Ross Cruz is inside for ball one. Knight working from the stretch, runners on first and second, comes set, delivers the 1-0, this is outside and away. Making the count two balls and no strikes. He comes back onto the mound. On deck, the catcher, John Pollock. Knight comes set and delivers a 2-0. Inside and low, making it three balls and no strikes. I have a feeling Knight walks this one. One of the coaches are going to come out. Either that be Nick Hayes or head coach Brian Fitzgerald. One of them will come out. Next pitch on the inside corner of the plate for strike one. Now in the last batters, Knight has been letting the batter take the lead in the battle here and then starts to come back. So Knight comes set. Let's see what he can do here with the 3-1. Delivers to the dish, hitting him for ball four. And here comes head coach Brian Fitzgerald, as I knew he would. The bases are loaded with no outs for John Pollock. Very likely going to be a pitching change here. Knight allowed one hit in his tenure as pitcher in today's game, facing ...19 batters. Or we may not have a pitching change. Fitzgerald is just out on the mound talking. Oh, I think we are. Dalton Lynn comes out from the dugout or bullpen. He might have been warming up. I didn't see him over there warming up. And we're going to have a pitching change. Dalton Lynn coming in to pitch. As we let him warm up, we're going to break. Dogs leading 12-0 in the top of the fifth inning on Y101.
Good job, Kyle.
Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Dogs leading 12-0. Kyle Knight pitched a really good game, only allowing one base hit. Hoping for the hitter. But no runs were scored. That's how many strikeouts he had. Two strikeouts. See how many walks he had. Two walks, and he had 1-2-3 hit by pitches.
Next up for Screven, number 11, Pollock, and number 7,
Knight pitched an excellent game today, only allowing a hit. But up to pitch now is Junior Dalton Lynn, the oldest Lynn out here today. His brother, not playing today. He has been running for either Cole Graham or Kyle Knight. The lights are coming on here at Jackie Jones. First pitch from Lynn gets away from catcher Jaden Carroll back into the fence. For ball one, bases are loaded now. So it could break up this shutout that Toombs County has going. Let's see. Corners are playing back, which, you know, I mean, you're leading 12-0. I guess you can afford to let at least one run score. Next pitch over the outside corner of the plate for a strike. Counts one ball and one strike. Dalton Lynn, probably wanting to get the win here tonight, had a very sad loss down in Screven County, hitting the batter to walk in a run, making it a 6-5 win for Screven. Here's the 1-1. This ball's going to be hit on the ground to Alex Gordy. Gordy doesn't get the ball, and now it goes to the left field. One run's going to score, and another run's going to score. Here comes the throw in. So Toombs County's not going to get a shutout here today, but we're still leading 12-2. So two runs scored. So now you have runners on second and third. With no outs, to bring up Jonathan Roberts. So, well, one of those runs were earned. It was the only base hit of the game.
Next up for the Gamecocks.
I'm scoring that as an error.
Roberts from number 20, Keyshawn Roberts from the
day. Honestly, I scored batting harder on the visiting team than our team. Which is just natural. No, it's not really a biased decision. I mean, he got some glove on it. So, I mean, I'm going to have to score it as an error. Just like Martin Stevens hit to the first baseman. It was a hard hit, but he got some glove on it. Scored as an error. So up to bat is Jonathan Roberts, who's 0-1 today with a hit by a pitch and flying out to center fielder Dalton McBride. Here's the pitch from Dalton Lynn, a curveball, hit back on the ground to Alex Gordy, fields it, fires over to third, in, not in time for the out, and another run scores to make it 12-3. So, Hayes is coming out to talk to his infield. The Dogs make a few minor adjustments on the infield, and all of a sudden you have three runs up on the scoreboard. Which, being a former player of this sport, I have to realize I'm on open air. There are some anger things that I would like to say out there that are best to keep it inside. And I know there had to be some things, times when Barney got upset. But Barney always did a great job of keeping his composure. One thing I guess I need to work on more. I have to score that as a base hit. Everything was clean across the infield as far as catching and throwing. Just not in time, so scoring as a base hit. So the score is 12-3 here at Jackie Jones Field. Here in the top of the fifth inning with Keyshawn Roberts up to bat. Played left field today and is 0-1. Grounding into a fielder's choice and a walk. Here's the throw from Dalton Lynn. Runner's going. Here's the throw down to second. Here's the tag. Slides in safely. So now you have runners in scoring position. I can feel it. I can feel the anger right here in my chest. Competitiveness, not really anger, just plain out being competitive. So head coach Fitzgerald is coming out onto the field. I guess he's going to protest that call. Reading the umpire's body language, that's exactly what's happening. So strike one on Keyshawn Roberts with runners down to second and third. Don't think he's going to get the call overturned. I just don't see it happening. Because even if you ask for help, this home plate umpire certainly didn't see it. I mean, at that, he didn't even have a good view on seeing it. The home plate umpire is now walking out there. I just don't see them overturning this call. Dogs leading 12-3, top of the fifth inning. Yeah, like I said, this call is not going to be overturned. Fitzgerald walking off the field. The home plate umpire walking back. Runners on second and third, no outs. I mean, what you don't want here is a big comeback in the top of the fifth inning. I mean, we don't want a replay of what happened down in Sylvania. That was a heartbreaking loss. Bases loaded, two outs, and hit by a pitch to walk in the last run, or the winning run. So no balls and one strike on Keyshawn Roberts as he steps in. A pretty big guy batting fourth today. Here's the pitch. A nice breaking ball in for a strike, nothing in two. By Dalton Lynn. He's faced two batters so far, allowing one base hit. Again, not the official score bookkeeper. Just doing it for myself. Lynn working from the windup. So used to saying stretch. I like to say stretch more than the windup. Lynn's working from the windup, delivers the 0-2. This ball's going to be hit high up into the air in the left field. Trey Cloud going to have a tag up here. Here's the catch and here's the throw. It's going to be cut off by Alex Gordy. And we're going to score another run here on a sacrifice fly by Keyshawn Roberts. So it's 12-4 here in the top of the fifth inning. One down to bring up number 17, Dawson Griffin. He was 0 for 2 today. He's stepping back in, runner at second. Here's the pitch from Mr. Lynn, low. Ball one. Dalton Lynn working from the stretch now. Comes set and delivers the 1-0. Gets away from catcher Jaden Carroll, and Keyshawn Roberts is down to third. So Dawson Griffin steps back in. Dalton Lynn now working from the windup once again. Comes set and delivers a 2-0. Low for ball three. Griffin steps back in. Dog still leading 12-4. And here's a 3-0 from Lynn in for a strike to make it three balls and one strike. On deck, shortstop Jordan Hodges. So Lynn working from the windup, comes set. Runner at third and delivers the 3-1. This ball's gonna be hit onto the ground to second baseman Noah Anderson. Fields it, throws it to first in time for out number two, but another run scores. So So what was a 12-0 is now 12-5. Dogs are still leading with two down to bring up Jordan Hodges.
Next up, Hodges.
Who is 0-2 today with a ground out to the third baseman Harrison at the time and a ground out to shortstop Bryce DeLoach. Here's the pitch from Lynn, high. You have no runners on base. Ball one. Bulldogs coming up to bat, I'm not sure. I want to keep you in suspense. It's a good way to go out into commercial. Here's the 1-0, low for ball two. I'll mark that down in my book as a strike. Two balls and no strikes on Jordan Hodges. Dalton Land comes set, delivers the 2-0. Also low. Now counts three balls and no strikes. On deck is number 8, Mock. I remember him from the game down in Sylvania. Hunter Mock. Here's the 3-0, and for ball four. So runner at first, two down, to bring up Hunter Mock. So he's stepping in, runner at first.
Next up for Screven County, number 8, Mock, with number 10, Boyd on deck. Two down.
So we're waiting, making the changes with the umpire here. Sorry, apologize for the dead air. Seems like we're getting that done. Anything takes the longest in baseball. It's the changes that have to be made with the umpires. It's always with this one behind the plate. I guess the one behind the plate is always considered the head umpire. Even in Major League Baseball, when you have, let's see, you have three field infield umpires. I think you have two outfield that stand down the foul lines, I believe. This pitch to him is going to be hit out into shallow right center field. He's going to drop it for a base hit. Don McBride gets it. Here's the throw all the way to third. Alex Gordy not able to catch the ball. Ricochets off his glove, and he's going to get down to second. So, you're going to score it as a base hit, getting a double. So, runners on second and third with two down to bring up the DH today, number 10, Wilson Boyd, who is 1-2. In for a strike. Nothing in one. On Wilson Boyd, steps back in, batting from the left-hand side. Lynn, of course, pitches from the right, and this is Dalton Lynn we're speaking of. Comes set and delivers the 0-1.
Nice.
Breaking ball in for a strike. Now the count's nothing and two.
The pitch, D. Lynn.
So nothing and two on Chase Thompson. I think my most dreaded part is having to go through and do the earned and unearned runs. Kind of tedious. Next pitch is going to be poked out into right left field for a base hit. It's going to score one. And at the beginning of this inning, what started out as a 12-0 lead is now slowly, it's now 12-6. Day. I'm getting kind of. trying to keep calm.
Next up, number 4.
12-6. Here in the top of the fifth inning.
Two down.
TV and radio, and even the newspaper, if you want to go that far, always has to keep its composure. Only runners on first and, yes, runners on first and third. That was an RBI single for Wilson Boyd. Two down, it brings up Carson Becton. Pitch is over his head for ball one. Batting from the right-hand side as he steps back in. Here's the 1-0 from Lynn. Swing and a miss. One. Lynn pitching from the stretch. His father, Coach Matt Lynn, is in the dugout with the iPad, keeping books. I guess he would be considered the official scorekeeper. Next pitch, runner going. Here's the throw. On time, tag is made. He is out. So that is out number three. But Screven County comes in here in the top of the fifth and scores six runs to make it what was a 12-0 lead, a 12-6 lead. So we're going to take a break. And going into the bottom of the fifth with Cloud, Harrison, and Stevens on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones. Dogs still leading, 12-6. Here in Jackie Jones Field. In the last inning, Ross Green. I don't know. When he comes up to the batter's box, he's not like as calm as he does when he's out there on the mound. Because everyone looks a little bit taller than they actually do on the mound. Or at least a little bit taller on the mound than they actually do. Ozzy Osbourne, keeping us upbeat from here. Jackie Jones Field with Crazy Train. Again, the 2018 Lions Citizen of the Year is Ramon Powell. Barney bands are still on sale. The cost is $5. They are orange. And they say praying for Barney. All proceeds goes towards Barney Bonfield. T-shirts are also on sale for Barney. See Megan Morris or any other of the Dogs Against Cancer representatives or members. They're $15 a piece, and I think they're $17 for larger sizes. And all proceeds goes directly towards Barney for medical expenses. So Harrison on deck, Cloud. I was about to combine Train, Cloud, and all in one. Cloud up to bat, who is 1-for-2 today with a walk. First pitch from Cruz is in for a strike. Nothing in one. So after this inning, any type of run rule effect is over. It turns into a full ball game, regardless. You could be beating them 90-something to zero. And you score, let's just say, all of your runs in the sixth inning, regardless, still have to play the rest of the game. So Cloud's going to hit this, a hard hit ball down the first baseman. He has it. Slips on first for the out. So up to bat, Harrison, who is 1-for-2 today with a walk. Here's the pitch. Ball's going to hit high up into the air. Will it stay in play, though, is the question. Third baseman, Jonathan Roberts, runs over and makes the catch for out number two. So two down, throwing up Martin Stevens, who is 2-for-3 on the night with an RBI single, reaching on an error by the first baseman, and a two-run RBI single. Stevens, of course, batting from the left-hand side. Tallest Bulldog on the team. Here's the pitch to him. Swing and a miss. No balls and one strikes on Stevens. No balls and one strike on Stevens. Steven's coming out, going down to talk to Coach Hunter Adams. Fitzgerald back in the dugout. So Martin Stevens coming back. Bottom of the fifth inning, dogs leading 12-6. So far, I was calculating the earned and unearned runs. I believe so far I had four as unearned. I didn't make it all the way through. Martin Stevens gonna hit this chopper down on the ground. It bounces over the glove of the second baseman. I'm gonna score it as a base hit because he had to run to it and it hit something in the grass, the base of the grass and the dirt, back out in deep second base territory and bounced over the glove. So a base hit by Stevens to make himself going 3-for-4 tonight. So a two down and a runner at first is going to bring up Cole Graham, who is 0-for-2 with a walk. So Graham steps up.
Number 26, Graham with the bat from number 18, with drive on deck. Two down.
Come on, Cole. Do a good job.
Graham stepping in. Two down, runner at first. Cruz comes, sets, delivers to the dish, is off the plate for ball one. Cruz looking down the barrel, receiving his sign from catcher John Pollock. Come set, here's the pitch, also off the plate for ball two. So two balls and no strikes on Graham. Cruz coming set, delivers to the dish, in for a strike. Counts two balls and one strike on Graham. Cruz comes set and delivers to one. It's going to be a ball. Stevens gets down to second. He counts three balls and one strike on the junior catcher, Cole Graham. Here at Jackie Jones today. Cruz, receiving the sign from catcher John Pollock. Comes set, working from the stretch, delivers the 3-1, high for ball four. Two runners on first and second to bring up Dalton McGrine, who is 0-for-2, or 1-for-3 today, or 1-for-2 today with a walk. Don't worry, three times is the charm. The only little error I had, we're gonna send in a runner for Cole Graham, number 3, Chandler Lynn.
Next up for the Dogs, number 18, Dalton McBride. And number 7, Dalton Lynn.
So McBride steps back in. Or steps in to begin. Did I say step back in? I meant step in. Steps in. Cruz, working from the stretch, runners on first and second, comes set, gives a look back at Stevens on second, swing and a miss, strike one by McBride. Cruz, working from the stretch, getting the sign from catcher Pollock, comes set, gives a look at Martin on second and delivers the 0-1, nice breaking ball. Strike two. No balls and two strikes on Dalton McBride. Cruz comes set, giving a look at his runners. and delivers the 0-2 swing. Knocks this one on the ground down to the third baseman. Roberts picks it up, fires to first, not in time. Runners everywhere are safe. I'm sure that's a base hit for Dalton McBride. Bases are loaded with two down for Kyle Knight. Where Dalton Lynn is batting? Yes, Dalton Lynn.
Number seven, Dalton Lynn.
Good thing I heard that before I gave my big spiel. I was about to say Kyle Knight hit a grand slam with two outs, but of course Knight's not batting. Came out of the game. Pitched a magnificent game, allowing one run, or one hit, not one run. So with two down and bases are loaded, here's Dalton Lynn. Not to say he can't do the same. Sort of a check swing on the first one. Ball one. Lynn. Steps in. Bases are loaded. Dogs leading 12-6 here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Here's the pitch from Cruz. Getting away from the catcher, Stevens, no go. So ball two on Lynn. And we will take Hawkins, too. Any run that touches the plate is a run that counts. So Cruz working from the windup now. Bases are loaded. Two down. Comes set and delivers the 2-0. High for ball three. So three balls and no strikes on Dalton Lynn, junior Bulldog, the oldest Lynn on the team today. Chandler is running for Graham. He's out at second. Here's the 3-0. High for ball four. Run's going to walk in to make it 13-6. And Screven County coach is coming out. For Willie Campbell, the bases are going to be juiced with two down. I'm not sure if we're going to make a pitching change here or not. It's probable. Oh, we are. It's going to be handed off to Jonathan Roberts, the third baseman. And Ross Cruz is going to move over to third base. We're going to take a break. Dogs leading 13-6 in the bottom of the fifth as we break on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field in the bottom of the fifth inning. Dogs leading 13-6 in a non-region matchup between the Screven County Gamecocks and the Toombs County High School Bulldogs. Pitching now is Jonathan Roberts. Ross Cruz faced 10 batters, allowing one strikeout, two walks, three hits. And allowing three runs.
Hey, let's go!
One of which one. So up the pitch now, Jonathan Roberts. Willie Campbell's gonna hit this one on the ground, second baseman. Second baseman fields it, has it, fires to first in time for out number three. So we're gonna go in the top of the sixth inning. Dogs leading 13-6 up to bat for Screven County, Cruz, Pollock, and Roberts on Y101. Top of the sixth inning, Dogs leading 13-6. Everyone re-entered the game. Graham back behind the dish. Maloche down at short. Harrison down at third. Stevens over at first. Anderson at second. Cloud down in left. McBride down in center. And Campbell out in right. One run.
Leading off the Gamecocks on top of the six.
Oh, no, six. Nine. There's 12. He scored one that inning, which was unearned. Yeah. So up to bat is Carson Becton. Yeah, this is Carson Becton.
Lovett.
Oh, okay. Actually, no, this is Edward Lovett. He went back into bat for himself. Yeah, put out on the base pads. In the fifth inning. So we're on the top of the sixth here. Edward Lovett back up to bat. Here's a large chopper on the ground. Noah Anderson fields it, throws it to first in time for the out. So one down to bring us back to the top of the order. For Ross Cruz, who has had two hit by a pitches today. Or two hit by pitch today, I'm not sure you would say that. Dogs leading 13-6, here's the pitch to the plate. It's in for a strike in the outside corner. Ross Cruz has two hit by pitches and got it into a fielder's choice. Lynn comes set, delivers the 0-1. This ball's going to be hit on the ground hard to Noah Anderson. Fields it, throws it to first, in time for the out. So two down to bring up catcher John Pollock.
Number 11, John Pollock up the bat. With number 7, Roberts on deck. Two down.
Jonathan Roberts is on deck, the pitcher for Screven County currently. Here's the pitch inside. Ball one. Pollock is 0 for 3 today. With a fielder's choice, a ground out of the third baseman, Harrison, and reaching on an error by the third baseman. It was Alex Gordy at that time. Next pitch is in for a strike. Counts even at 1. Lynn pitching from the windup. Comes set and delivers the 1-1. This ball's gonna be hit back up the middle for a base hit. Just gonna see if DeLurch was able to scoot to it. That was a hard hit back up the middle. So a runner on first with two down to bring up Jonathan Roberts. Batting from the right hand side. Who is 1 for 2 today with an RBI single, a hit by a pitch, and a fly out to center fielder Dalton McBride, not necessarily in that order. It's hit by a pitch, fly out to Dalton McBride, and then reaching on an RBI single in the 5th. Currently in the 6th inning. Lynn comes set, working from the stretch. Delivers the pitch. This ball's going to be popped up high up into the air, into the sort of evening sky here at Jackie Jones to Noah Anderson for out number 3. So we move into the bottom of the 6th. Dogs leading 13-6 on Y101. Welcome back to the top, bottom of the 6th inning, up to bat for Toombs County, Noah Anderson, Bryce DeLoach on deck, coming back in to bat for himself. Dogs leading 13-6 in the bottom of the 6th inning. About ready to begin. Noah Anderson, 1 for 2 today with a hit by a pitch. Double, reaching on an error by the first baseman. Not necessarily in that order. Starting double, reaching on an error by the first baseman. And a hit by a pitch. As the senior dog steps into the plate.
We have number 16, Noah Anderson up the bat. And number 10, Bryce DeLoach.
Jonathan Roberts, the pitcher, doing a pretty nice job. Where did he come in? Did I mark it? Did not. First pitch to Anderson is a ball. Roberts working from the stretch. Thought I marked it. Well, if not, I'll figure it out in just a second. Give him a break. Next pitch inside for ball 2. It's 2 balls and no strikes on Anderson. As he steps back in, Roberts, here's the pitch, ball 3. 3 balls and no strikes on Noah Anderson. starting to get in my head who I'm going to interview for tomorrow's sports report, and it's probably also carry over into Monday's. Next pitch is in for a strike, which they have a game tomorrow too, which Martin Stevens is definitely one I'm going to interview. Had an excellent day at the plate. Next pitch to Anderson. Ball four. So runner at first to bring up Bryce DeLoach.
Number 10, Bryce DeLoach up the bat. Number 12, Trey Cloud on deck.
Cloud is on deck. So you're going to have to interview Stevens. He was 4-for-4 today. For offensive lines, I'm going to have to interview Stevens. Let's see. That's been it. Defensive wise, I'm going to interview Kyle Knight, pitching. First pitch to DeLoach, ball one. Next pitch is going to be hit on the ground. Third baseman not able to get to it. Base hit for Bryce DeLoach. So runners on first and second. With no outs.
Number 12, Trey Cloud.
For Trey Cloud. Dogs can't score some insurance runs. Which, I will not say that comment. Karma is a terrible thing. Here's a pitch to Cloud. Low and outside. Ball one. Cloud steps back in on the night. He is 1-for-3 with a walk. Here's the pitch, outside and low for ball two. Here's the 2-0 to Cloud, inside for ball three. On deck is Brock Harrison, and then after him, Martin Stevens. Had a great day at the plate. Here's the 3-0 for ball four. So the bases are loaded. To bring up Brock Harrison. So Screven County's coach is going to come out and probably make another change in pitching, because he does do that. I don't know if we're going to make a change. Yeah, we're making a change. Anytime the coach gives the good old pat on the back, that means a change is being made in pitching. Let's see, I'm wanting to see his number. Is that 23? Number 23 is Jordan Hodges, the shortstop. He's coming into pitch, so as he warms up, we're going to take a break. Dogs leading 13-6, bottom of the sixth on Y101. Welcome back to Jackie Jones Field in the bottom of the sixth inning. Brock Harrison hits this one out to center field, and Noah Anderson is going to tag up. And Bryce DeLoach is going to get down to third. Trey Cloud is going to hold up at first. So a sack fly for Harrison to drive in a run to make it 14-6. So with one down, that's going to bring up Martin Stevens. Had a magnificent day at the plate, 4-for-4. Let's see if he can't keep the perfect batting average going. With runners on the corners. Jordan Hodges is up to bat. Martin's going to hit this one, and he's 5-for-5 today as he scores a run on RBI single. I was persuaded to change the first thing I had for Stevens on the reaching on an error by the first baseman in the third. Decided to change it. And also, Brian Graham, sitting up here with me, running the scoreboard, announcing the name, said he's given him 4-for-4. So I thought, you know, it probably was. The bases, runners are first and second, bases aren't loaded, one down. Bulldogs leading 15-6. First pitch to Graham over the outside edge for a strike. Graham has had two walks today. 0-for-2 with two walks. Here's the next pitch. He's going to hit this one on the ground. The shortstop, he fields it, fires it to second, in time for the out there, not in time for the double play. So two down to bring up Dalton McBride, senior Bulldog, who is 1-for-2 today with a hit by a pitch and reaching on a walk. Each walk to run in. Dogs leading 15-6 here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Sending in a runner for catcher Cole Graham, and that is freshman Chandler Lynn.
Number 18, Dalton McBride up the bat for number 7, Dalton Lynn on deck. Two down.
On deck, Dalton Lynn. Jordan Hodges comes set, runner going, no throw. Runners are now on second and third. For Dalton McBride, first pitch is in for a strike. So runners are in scoring position for the Dogs to take a greater lead, currently leading by 9. Here's the next pitch. Did he go? Yes, he did. Strike 2. So no balls and 2 strikes. I was just informed that if a run crosses the plate, the ball game is over. That could be it right here if Don McBride makes it. No, he does not. So we're going to go into the seventh inning on Y101. Dogs leading 15-6, if they can get 3 outs, the ball game's over on Y101. We're in the top of the seventh inning here at Jackie Jones Field. The game has lasted, let's see, started about 5:42. Almost 2.5 hours. We're just moving pretty fast. It's an upbeat game. The longest inning of the game was definitely the fourth and fifth inning for Toombs County. Dogs leading 15-6 here in the seventh inning. That'll bring up number 20, Keyshawn Roberts.
Number 20, Keyshawn Roberts up to bat. Number 17, Austin Griffin.
So let's see if the Dogs can get 3 outs here and end this game, this non-region game against Screven County. Here's the pitch from Lynn. This ball's going to be hit. What is it? It was a foul ball. I believe it came off of his foot. Strike 1. Sorry, I was fidgeting with the cord here. I sat on it and pulled the headset away from my ear. Next pitch, a nice breaking ball in for a strike. Nothing in 2. I remember many years ago, it was on Little Fenway at Parton Park. I was really young. I was doing a broadcast with Barney, a sports broadcast. So, and that was a while back. Next pitch fouled off. And I was doing something to the headphones. I was messing with the mic, I believe. Barney told me to get my hand off that thing, which it was making noises. But just the way the microphone works, I can touch the cord down here and you can hear it. I believe that was the first game. I guess you consider that helping call. I don't know how much of a help I was. Next pitch way off the plate for ball 1. I was at least 10, maybe 11. I was at least 10. The count's 1-2 on Keyshawn Roberts. Lynn comes set, working from the windup, and delivers the 1-2. Swings and fouls this one off into the dugout of the Toombs County High School baseball team. So 1-2 here in the top of the 7th inning. Dogs leading 15-6. 3 outs, the game's over. Lynn comes set and delivers the 1-2. This ball is hit back up the middle hard out in the center field for a base hit. So a runner up on first, bring up Dawson Griffin. Wearing number 17, 0 for 3 here today. Flying out to the left fielder, grounding into a fielder's choice, and hitting a sack grounder down to Noah Anderson. Here's the pitch, and for a strike. Counts nothing and one on Anderson. Not Anderson, sorry, Hodges. I was thinking of Anderson just a minute ago when I was talking about him grounding out. It was Noah Anderson. Next pitch is going to be hit deep into right center field. McBride coming over to get a glove on that ball, throwing it in. A nice throw, but a good hit by Dawson Griffin. So back-to-back singles for Screven County. Bring up number 23, Jordan Hodges.
Next up, number 23, Hodges, with number 8, Mock.
On deck, Hunter Mock. Jordan Hodges is 0 for 2 today with a walk, playing the shortstop position, and then came to pitcher. Here's the pitch, outside, ball one, runners on the corners, no outs as we're in the top of the 7th inning. Lynn comes set, working from the stretch, and delivers to the dish, and for a strike. Now the count's even at 1. He steps back in. Lynn, working from the stretch, gives a look at his runners on the bases. Comes set and delivers the 1-1. This ball's going to be hit out in the right field. It's going to score one run. And it gets by Willie Campbell and rolls out. Another run is going to score. The ball's getting in. So two runs just scored to make it 15-8. One was earned. The other was unearned. I consider that on an error. He scored another run. I'm going to score it as a single, but got a triple out of it.
Number 8, Miles up the bat. And number 2, Thompson.
Scoring 2 runs. Well, I guess they were technically earned. The runners on base got on by base hits. So a runner at third with no outs. 15-8, top of the 7th inning. Here's the pitch from Lynn. Off the plate for ball 1 to Hunter Mock, who is 1-for-1 in today's game. Started batting in the 5th inning and had a base hit. Lynn, pitching from the windup, comes set and delivers. He wanted to call it a strike, but decided not to. Counts 2 balls and no strikes on Hunter Mock. Comes set, pitching from the windup, and delivers the 2-0. In for a strike, there we go. Make it 2-1. So he comes back on. Gives a look at the runner at third, comes set and delivers the 2-1 pitch. This ball's going to be hit foul. Right field side, way out of play, over into the pit. To make the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Hunter Mock wearing number 8, batting from the right hand side. Count is 2 balls and 2 strikes. Lynn, working from the windup, comes set and delivers the 2-2. Pops this one up foul, just out of play. Back over here toward the Screven County Gamecock fan base. So Lynn coming back onto the mound. Comes set, winding, and delivers the 2-2. Nice pitch. Guess it was inside. Load up the count. On Hunter Mock. And pitching from the windup, comes set, and is delivering the full count pitch. Ball's gonna be fouled off, hitting one of the poles that is using to hold up the fence. And bounced right back out there to Dalton Lynn. So Lynn comes set, gives a look at his runner on third, and delivers the full count pitch. Low for ball 4. So there are no outs. Seems like we have another batter. That's number 9. Number 9 is Stevon Lewis. So I'm going to pronounce it. Or Stephen. S-T-E-P-H-O-N. Usually Stephen spelled with an E-N, but...
Number 9, Lewis up the bat. Number 1, Lovett.
There are different ways to say it. Or spell it. I'm just going to go with Stephen. Stephen Lewis is up to bat. Runners on the corners with no outs. Looking for a double play ball and giving up the run. That's on third. So Lamb comes set, gives a look at his runners. Delivers to the plate and signs for ball 1. He comes set, runners on first and third, delivers to the dish, and for a strike, counts even at 1. He steps in. Lynn pitching from the stretch, runners on the corners. Top of the 7th inning, Dogs leading 15-8, here's the pitch, and for a strike. Counts 1 ball and 2 strikes on Stephen Lewis. Lynn, receiving the sign from catcher Graham, comes set and delivers to the plate. This ball is going to be hit foul, first base side. It's going to roll down into right field. Out the field is left-handed. Just found that out. The ball that was hit foul, thrown in by Willie Campbell, rolled to him. He threw it back into the plate. Left-handed. Interesting. Or he might can throw with both. Who knows? So 1 ball and 2 strikes on Stevon Lewis, or Stephen Lewis. I want to say Stevon, just because of the way it's spelled. That's Stephen Lewis, and a swing and a miss. Strike 3 for out number 1. to bring up number one, Edward Lovett. He was 0 for 2 today, reaching on an error by the third baseman and grounding out to second baseman Noah Anderson. Lynn comes set and delivers to the dish. Nice pitch. I'm not sure where that was. Maybe a little high. That's all that it could be. It was definitely over the plate. Here's the pitch. Inside. Now I can see where that one was the ball. Definitely not the one before it. Counts 2 balls and no strikes on Edward Lovett. Lynn comes set, working from the stretch, delivers to the dish, in for a strike. Counts now 2 balls and 1 strike on number one for the Screven County team. You said Benedictine there. So the count's 2 balls and 1 strike on Lovett. Lynn comes set, winding, and delivers this pitch to the plate. This ball is going to be fouled off back into the pit. Make the count even at 2. On deck, Ross Cruz. Lynn, giving a look at his runners on base, comes set and delivers the 2-2, which is off the plate for ball 3 to load up the count. Lynn stepping onto the mound. Dogs leading 15-8 here in the top of the 7th. There's the full count pitch. Knocks this one foul. Lynn comes set and delivers the full count pitch. Called strike 3. So 2 down to bring up Ross Cruz. Dogs 1 out away from winning this non-region game here at Jackie Jones.
Number 3 Cruz up the bat, and number 11 Pollock on deck. 2 down.
So with 2 down, brings up Ross Cruz, who on the night is 0 for 2 with 2 hit by pitch. He was hit by a pitch twice. There we go. Here's the first pitch off the plate for him. Ball 1. Lynn comes set. Runners on the corners. 2 down. Delivers to the dish. This ball's going to be hit up into the air. Will Harrison be able to get to it, or will it go out of play? Harrison makes the catch for out number 3 in foul territory, and that is your ball game. Dogs winning 15-8 here in 6.5 innings. We'll take a break and come back and wrap it up on your home of the Dogs, Y101.